Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mangs, and I welcome you guys to part 7 of Let's Play Fire Emblem Radiant Dawn. I brought someone with me here today, say hello.
Don't you mean Raydiant Dawn?
Oh, I see what you did there. Well, it's Mr. A, none other than Mage Knight 404 himself, joining me on co-commentary today. I don't know
How's
where Mr. Antinen is, he's probably passed out in a ditch somewhere after drinking too much rum, so...
Wow, grim.
You know, those Finnish people, they just don't know how to stop. Yeah, so Ray hasn't actually seen any of my former parts, because at the time of recording this, part 1 is due to be released tomorrow. So, yeah, I guess I'm gonna have to show you my party.
I am extremely hyped for this shit. You have no idea how hyped I am for this LP.
I'm already very hyped for it. I'm having a fucking great time with this game.
Now this is a game I don't like, and I'm already hyped for shit for this.
I imagine if it was a game you did like. Alright, well, the thing is, like, the gameplay is solid. I'm just gonna have to reposition my units around here. I think, you see these little things right here, right?
Yeah.
I can't see them.
I do.
I'm colorblind. Oh. I'm colorblind, I can't see them. I only know that they're there, and I think there's some here.
Yeah, yeah, they are. There are some there.
The first time I tried to play this map, Mr. Antinen was like, Mangs, what the fuck are you doing? And I was like, well, I have to choke these two points right here, right? So I placed, like, units here, and I placed units here. And he was like, what are you doing?
Yeah,
and
see, there was a problem with that little thing. Those are just empty space.
Yeah, so apparently now I've been informed that these are holes. So, thanks, game.
Yeah, holes.
For being a dick to colorblind people. Alright, so, yeah, this game is hard. Allow me to show you my party, Ray. So, allow me to show you first my MVP of this Let's Play. Here's Edward.
Edward! Based Edward has come! I love this man. I love Edward. He's one of my favorite characters.
He has been so fucking good this entire Let's Play. He's leveled defense 3 times. His speed and strength, just amazing.
His strength, skill, and speed growths are all 50 and higher, so...
Yep. Yeah. Love this guy. Absolutely love this guy. And, of course, here is Miss Tinfoil, Micaiah. I hate her.
Yeah, that sounds about right. She looks pretty average so far.
I swear to God, I have restarted so many times because of Micaiah. It is absolutely fucking painful.
Yeah, get used to that. That happens quite a bit if you're just playing carelessly.
Yep, and of course, the god himself. Thank you, Soth, for being part of this game. I don't know what I would do.
I see you have forged a knife. I assume that was Mr. Antonin's advice.
That was Mr. Antonin's advice. He's...
Good advice. Forged knives are very good.
Brolin got the dragon shield.
Good. He could use the extra bulk.
Yeah, problem is he gets doubled by everything in the grandmother, though.
He needs a couple strength procs and he'll be good. Klein, he has a really good speed growth.
Yeah, Kleinhair is benched. I'm just bringing him to... He's just fucking terrible.
Leonardo is not very good. I'm not surprised you're benching him so soon.
Aaron has been surprisingly helpful ever since he leveled speed. So
He needs every bit of speed leveled up again since he gets lots of strength, skill, and defense. But other than that, yeah.
Yeah.
He is reliable once he gets going.
Go away. And the mage that I freaking love, but every time I say I'm going to use Ileana, Antinen gets a fucking heart attack in rage. Because apparently something about her leaving, I think he has some issues with girls leaving him.
Through the closed doors, the things I'm not privy to.
Well, I just remember Ileana from the last game, and I freaking loved Ileana in that game. But every time I want to use her, he just gets so angry, and he's like, "She leaves you, Mangs. She leaves you." And I'm like, "Well, you know, maybe we should just try to have fun with her while it lasts. You know, no need to be so upset." All right, so. I freaking love Fanny, by the way. It's my freaking favorite.
Fanny is pretty much Micaiah's saving grace. Without that, she'd kind of be just a run-of-the-mill power mage.
I mean, I use Fanny simply because of its amazing might.
It's really good. It is such amazing, just clipping through armor and calves.
Yep.
Absolutely devastating.
Alright, so I think Edward has a support with Brolin. No, with Leonardo, actually. Okay. So now that I know that this is actually a choke point, I can place him next to the healing fountain. Oh, wind sword. Yeah, why not? I could always trade it. Yeah, wind edge is pretty good, but I'm finding it doesn't really hit a lot.
No, its base accuracy is only 60. It's just like a basic javelin. Even this game had the smart idea to introduce a physical ranged weapon thing for swords. Too bad they just don't have the actual hit to make it work. So javelins and especially hand axes are just far outstripped the fact of the wind edges and its family.
Yeah, I learned that these support conversations are pretty fucking dull.
No, that's the problem with everyone being able to support with everyone else.
Yeah, I see.
You can just function like classic Fire Emblem, where you just have supports do this and this and that, and just they just do a flat bonus. But yep. Here, they don't have any specific conversations. What a character development!
Yeah, I was a little bit disappointed to see that actually. So, I think I remember. I'm gonna send Soth up here, so I'm actually gonna break down this wall. I think. Because there are some hidden items here. If I remember correctly, there's something over here.
There is a scroll here, and you kind of want that scroll, because it'll be helpful in later maps.
Yeah. And then I also think there is something... Is there a master seal down here?
Yes, there is indeed a master seal down there.
Well, the master seal's...
Right where Micaiah is standing.
Yeah?
Right where Micaiah is standing, along that line, along that triple line of gold, is a coin.
Aha, I see. Okay, cool. By the way, no. Just thought I'd say.
Poor Meg. An otherwise really good, or otherwise really good unit. Sandwiched in between this super difficult game.
I would just like to, you know, repeat a phrase that I think sums up her character pretty well. Shut up, Meg.
Sounds about right.
I don't know. I saw her growth rates. They reminded me of Wendy. I was not impressed.
She is basically Wendy version 2.0.
Hit point, strength, speed.
Oh,
speed.
Aaron, what a guy. Speed, yes.
Gotta go fast, man. What the hell? They're just not gonna attack Soth? I guess not. Yeah, I'm having difficulties adjusting to how the lagoos work in this game.
Allow me to inform you all of the mighty lagoos and how they work, unless Mr. Entident did it for you.
He did, but the thing is, I can't understand half of the things he say. So, from what I understand, they kind of like... They're a little bit more reminiscent to Manakits in the previous games.
Yes, this time they're a lot more like FE3 Manakits in that they can transform... They can build the gauge. The gauge is dependent on the race of the goose they are, and this time they can choose to transform at will once their gauge hits 30.
Ah, okay, I see.
Once their gauge transforms, and once they transform, their stats double instead of being given specific bonuses.
I see. Okay. So, but yeah, I just find it terribly confusing at times because I have to like, because fucking hard mode doesn't want to show me how far units can move. Thanks, by the way. I have to like...
Nope, hard mode. Radiant Dawn sends its regards.
But seriously, I enjoy a difficult game, but removing game, like basic gameplay features such as checking enemy range.
That gets on my tits, too. That's one of the reasons why I really like hard mode. Because it's just, let's just buff the enemies up and let's take these features for no specific reason other than for the sake of, air quotes, difficulty.
Yeah,
that's fair.
It just seems very strange to me, you know. They could have just increased their stats on them a little bit and allowed me to view range. And also, one thing I really don't like is the removal of the weapon triangle, because I feel like they take away a very core aspect of the game. Oh, fuck, I didn't want to talk to you. Go away. No. Like, I feel like, you know, you take away one of my toys. I really enjoy the weapon triangle. It's a very strategic element of the game.
Edward enjoys the weapon triangle. He gets that face on hard mode all the damn time.
Well, I do enjoy beating up Myrmidons with Brolan, though. What does it say max here? Does that mean he's ready to transform?
Yes, that means he will be able to transform as soon as he can.
Okay, I see. Well, hello there.
By the way, unshifted Lagoos count as tier 1 units, while shifted Lagoos count as tier 2 units.
Yeah, I do believe Mr. Antonin mentioned that, so you get more experience for fighting them, pretty much. Okay, that is bad. Mm-hmm. We do not want to do that. Maybe we could throw a javelin at this guy? Yeah, sure, why not? Yeah, I mean, like, they are ridiculously easy to kill, though, while they're untransformed.
Oh, yeah, that's the problem when having your stats double when you're shifted. They become pathetically easy to kill when they're unshifted. As opposed to just mildly easy to kill back in Path of Radiance.
I see. You know, it's too bad Ileana is not available. You know, because I really, really like Ileana as a unit. I think she's, like, really fucking good. She doesn't...
She's okay in this game. Like, her bases are fine. It's just Thunder Magic sucks.
Why does it suck?
It's the lowest of might of all the magic types in this game, and they nerf, and it still has its crappy hit from all the other series.
Ah.
So not compensate. I guess because of the fact that it has inbuilt crits for most of its domes. But pretty much every other magic type is better.
I always felt like wind magic was never particularly good.
Wind magic here is really good considering that it has more might than thunder and actually has the best hit.
Hmm. Okay, cool. Alright, come on, Aaron. You can do this. Oh, this guy is beefy as fuck. These are the tigers, aren't they?
Tigers can flex and just run rush out all over your face. They're good at that.
Grrr! You need it, all humans? Come and fight!
Listen here, Band of Lagoons, we ain't having any of your sass.
Well, you know, we did just walk in here because Mary Sue here had a vision. You know, I kind of sympathize with these guys.
Oh. Pro soft crits.
Wow. And he didn't even kill
By
him.
By the way, love Battle of Pride, the boss theme. Freaking sweet.
Yeah, this game has some kick-ass music to it. It's too bad you can't hear it.
It's okay, I have a whole soundtrack, and while I can just run spew vitriol about this game as much as I want, the music of this game is pretty stellar. Ooh!
Don't double. No! Edward, no!
No, please.
Oh, fuck me. You know, this is the big problem with Edward, actually. This has killed him on numerous occasions. Whoops.
Eddie, no!
Oh, no. Well,
goodbye.
Well.
Hang.
Dang, and I was doing so well too. Well,
Eddie.
So let's restart. I have an official Manx fail counter, and I do believe this is number 15 or something like that.
Holy shit, already?
Yep. Pretty
Welcome
much.
To hard mode, Mangs. Enjoy your stay.
Hey, wait a minute. No, I didn't want to resume the goddamn chapter. Goddamn it. Well, you know, it's kind of difficult to... I really shouldn't choke the point with Edward. I'm aware of that because that shit can happen. And no, we don't want to be suspending. We want to go start chapter. Sure. I just hope that it remembers my battle preparations. Yeah, it does. Awesome. All right, let's continue. Alright, I think that moving Mikaia over here and Fanny bombing this tiger is a decent opener. At least that's what I feel.
I usually do that, if not sick Ileana against that guy.
Is Thunder Magic no way that's good against dragons, isn't it? It's fire magic, yeah. That's good against
fire,
beasts.
That
would actually have been really good.
Fire magic, by the way, is the strongest magic type in this game, without a doubt.
How so?
Not only does it have the most might, it actually has reliable hit most of the time.
Hmm, I see. Let us see. Yeah, so who should... I know I shouldn't put Edward here, but I don't know who else I'd put over here. Maybe Alan?
Oh. Aaron is a good choice. I would also honestly put Sav there, because the Goose is just going to knock down that door, that wall anyway.
Ah. Right, so have self-tank this pawn down. But shouldn't Soth go up and open the chests over here?
You can get them by just going around, though you're gonna have to play a little bit of baiting.
Okay, I see. Well, that's fine. I love this knife. This is a really handy trick.
Fortune knives are very good.
Oh, come on, Soth.
Look at him. He's like, no, my experience, friend.
I'm a Jagan. Jagans don't allow the other youngsters to grow up. true Jagans take all the experience for themselves.
So, if you have to choose, if you actually have to choose between the two chests up there, go for the right one. It's a stat booster.
Yeah, it's an energy drop, isn't it?
Seraph Robe.
Seraph Robe?
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Laura. Or maybe that's
not
a waste.
Not for you, Micaiah. Get away.
Maybe I should give it to Micaiah.
I usually give it to Micaiah, since Laura is still very squishy even with a robe.
Yeah, you know what? I think that's probably for the best. I mean, Micaiah gets freaking one-shotted by everything in this game, and it's actually starting to piss me the hell off.
What amp speed stat? Like, if it's not her, if it's not her frailty, it's her not very reliable speed growth of 35.
Yeah, but like, I think the worst part of it all is the fact that she has like 15 base hit points. Oh my god, Alan, no. Oh my god, he just got a speed level up in the last playthrough. please repeat this. Hit points, skill, speed! Yes!
What a guy! Yes. What a freaking guy. Oh. Base Aaron, always get speed.
Oh, thanks. Thanks a lot. Oh, right, hello. Some more. Okay. I must admit, I have difficulties taking the cats of this game seriously.
What's that?
I don't know, it's just like, we're fighting a tiger, we're fighting a hawk, and then suddenly it's like, meow! Hey. Besides, I just think of Leth, and I could never take Leth seriously from the previous game.
Could.
Because she was always so angry. Angry Leth.
Did Mr. Antenna go over the strikes about the Lagoos, their weapon type?
I don't think so.
Yeah, Lagoos can upgrade their weapon types in this game.
Really?
Yeah, they could, just by repeated use. They start at A rank, and when they go to S rank, their might increases by 5, and they go to double S rank, increases by another 5.
I see. Okay, that's kind of cool, actually. I like that. Alright, let's, throw a hand axe at this guy. Oh, ah, stop. Stupid for supports. They're so annoying. I was thinking we could try and, there's not so many enemies coming from this way, so we could set, like, Edward up here. I'm still undecided if I'm actually going to use Brolin, though. I mean, I did give the guy a dragon shield. But I feel like he's lagging behind a little bit due to not leveling speed. So I don't know.
Just give him a few more shots. If he doesn't keep leveling speed, then you're probably going to have to drop him and eventually use the other axe you're going to get in the next chapter.
It's weird, though.
Who actually does have speed?
It's weird, though, because his speed growth is actually insane, yet for some reason, he just doesn't level it. Oh, nice. Chest key. I get really confused by these chests, by the way. Like, there's chests here, but they're not chests. And they have gold in them, but we can't... I mean, what the hell,
these
game?
These are decorative chests! You can't touch them, man.
Yeah, but seriously, I mean, what the hell is up with that? Dick move, game. Dick move. Alright, so Alan actually... I wonder, does he get doubled now? Oh my god. He gets doubled by the can. But...
Javelin.
Any chance I have to do some damage to a Lagoose, I like. I had some serious issues getting over the ledges in this game. That was a very new mechanic to me.
Oh, the ledges. I actually really like the ledge mechanic.
It's cool, actually.
It's a good mechanic. But yeah, it takes some getting used to. Hello, plus minus 50 hit and 2 damage.
Yeah, and then I was like, there was one try. Oh my god. Yeah, cancel. Thanks, Archer, for having that skill. So useful.
You can remove that skill. Wait. Did Mr. Enten go over skills?
Yeah, I've already sold Meg's skill for 3,000. Thanks, Meg. That's your contribution to this team.
Good contribution, I must say.
Did we just shoot this guy out of cat form? What the hell?
Yes, you did. Because the gauge goes down even if you attack them at range. A very viable tactic, by the way.
Okay.
That tigers and cats lose a shitload of gauge if you attack them at range.
You can basically, like, knock them out of form.
Yeah.
Oh, here comes the wrath. Here comes the wrath. Oh, no. He needs to be under 30%, I've heard.
Yeah, 30%.
That just makes it more difficult to calculate, in my opinion.
Yeah, I honestly don't like the change either. I was going to just stick it at 50%. I mean, I know why they did that, but...
I mean, everyone can divide by 2, right? You know, that's easy. You know, you got 50 hit points, you know, wrath triggers at 25. It's easy, you know? But then it's like 30% is like, what is 30% of 36? Yeah, 12?
Mang's failing me.
Yeah, like, and if you know Mang's math, it is not something you want to rely on in combat. Alright. Oh fuck, they're going back to the healing wells. I must say, I like the healing wells. They're cool. They're kind of like
this
pillars.
This is the only map they appear in the game, though, so don't get too attached to them.
What? Why?
This game has a lot of good mechanics, but not very good execution with them.
But these would have been fantastic to have around. I really enjoy them.
I know, but yeah, this is the only map they appear in the game.
Hey, Meg, it's be useful. Go pick up treasure. Thanks.
There you go.
However, I did not manage to find a way to import my coins from the previous game.
Oh, that's a shame.
I checked around on the internet, and apparently it can be done, but it's really complicated. You need some external hardware.
Oh. I had no idea that was the case. Well.
Hit points, skill, luck. Come on, Roland!
I know your base level is 9, but you can get some speed, friend.
Well, I guess we can truly say that he is now no Lan.
Stop doing this to me.
Oh my god. Okay, well, let's kill this guy. And I guess we could use some sacrifice. There's actually one good reason to giving her the angel robe, I can imagine, and that is to be able to sacrifice more hit points.
Oh yeah, that's definitely a good way to use sacrifice.
I prefer to sacrifice with Micaiah and then just heal Micaiah, you know, to double dip in terms of experience.
I do that all the time. It really does work.
But yeah, it is a really cool skill. I enjoy it a lot. Alright, well, maybe we'll just kill this guy with Solf. It's not like I'm going to use Leonardo, so... I haven't really decided, like, I'm probably just going to use the units, the ones I like, I guess. Oh, by the way, Beast Killer, because we can.
Oh, good, you bought the Beast Killer.
Yep.
Very good.
36 damage with a 28%... What? Like, this is a fucking killing edge on crack.
Freaking hello, effective damage. I missed you. Were you in Path of Radiance?
Not around. Alright, so, yeah, I think I am going to attack this guy, even though it means I'll get hit back. Oh, wait, that 2% critical. Nope, 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 nope.
Smart Mangs.
Nope, 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 nope.
You don't mess with the 2%.
Okay, I don't want to break... This is not a wall. Yes, it is. But it's a wall, but it can't be broken.
It's a wall, but it's not a breakable one.
Okay, well, we'll just be careful. I know you get some bonus experience for quickly completing levels in this game, but from my experience, whenever I start rushing, I just end up dying. There you go, Alan. Attaboy. Go kill the cat.
Roar. No, don't mind me. I'm just going to transform and not be able to attack you.
But why didn't he go for... Oh, right. Right, right. I think I have a reason why he didn't go for Sol.
I'm gonna knife you once.
I'm just gonna go over here. You guys, you guys have fun with Lan. All right, let's heal up Micaiah, and I do believe I can kill this guy with Alan. Oh, nice. Oh, Laura level up. Laura level up. Come on, could you please get something other than skill, hit points, magic, skill, speed.
Laura's growths are very good.
She leveled defense.
That doesn't happen often, though, the defense level up. But yeah, the rest of her growths are very good. Her magic skill and speed are all 70, I think.
Well, rather than being killed by, like, 10 overkill in terms of damage, she will now be overkilled by 9 damage.
Very good, Laura. You're improving.
No.
It also doesn't help that the priest's caps in this game are low.
15 like speed cap? What the hell?
Yeah.
Like, who thought that was a good idea?
They really nerfed magic units in this game. Like, wow, they nerfed them pretty bad.
I think it's very sad, actually. You know, but there's just way too much one-shotting for my taste here. Let's see. I think I'll actually go and fetch the Master Seal with Soth. And then I think, combined, if Leonardo deals 6 damage to this guy, then Aaron should be able to deal 7 damage. 6 plus 7 is 13. That is not enough. Aha! Shut up, Meg. No, fuck.
Fine, man. We'll see you in hell, friend.
Okay, you know what? You know what, Arad? You have fun with this guy while Sloth steals the experience. Theoretically, we could just not attack the guy. That is also an option, I guess.
You could.
But then again, where's the fun in that? When we can beast killer the guy.
Might as well get as much leverage out of the beast killer here. It's only ever useful.
This should be called.
It's only ever useful in one other map where you're gonna be fighting hordes of beast killers.
Would be kind of cool if, like, when you kill the Lagoose with the beast killer, you got like a pelt out of it or something.
I was just thinking that same thing.
Skinning knife.
Skin a Lagoose, get a nice tiger pelt, increase defense.
Angelic tiger pelt.
Grow, puny little humans, come and fight.
Shut up, Agony. We've been through this song and dance already.
Are these like the Jasmine and Paul of this game?
Yeah. I love very much the Jasmine and Paul or Maggie and Rose, whatever.
Jasmine and Paul, Maggie and Rose, Vincent and Victor, Pain and Agony.
Except they're not flamboyantly gay. They just want to gnaw your teeth and let your flesh off. This nowhere near as fun.
I love their dialogue. Okay, I think if I this is nasty, actually. I think I'm gonna have to retreat without reduce a vulnerary. Maybe I'll just heal. This guy's beastly. And I do believe he doubles Nolan. 10 attack speed. Yeah, 14 attack speed.
Oh yeah, he's gonna get doubled.
We could smoke some pots and then heal up.
Smoke some sweet herb.
Yeah. The Dome Brigade is all about that. They wanna legalize herbs, man.
I don't think Ileana gets double, but she probably gets very close to being one-shotted, though. I don't know.
I'm gonna heal him up, naturally. Alright, well, let's see. This guy's healing up. I guess we can go and fetch the Master Seal. Maybe Soth can go and open that chest over there. If I use a Bronze Dagger, he probably won't kill the thing. I'm not sure if I should... I'm probably gonna leave Micaiah here, to be quite honest. You know, just so I can kill that boss. So the boss is...
You're so big.
Heals one hit point, get 10 experience. Aw, yeah.
You're so big and strong.
Magic, speed, luck, resistance. Typical Micaiah level up.
Speed!
Hey!
Except the speed.
Oh, you know. She got speed. Yeah. Okay, Leonardo, you can get the... What? You can't shoot over a bucket. Really?
No, you can't shoot over the barrel like that.
You know, archers make no sense in this game. From any logical perspective, this guy should have been able to shoot this guy with the bow. He's like, no, I have to walk up 2 feet close to you and shoot
besides,
you.
Besides,
with...
you go... Okay.
Leonardo, could you take a aim at the Lagoose guy? I'm sorry. I can't do that, Micaiah.
It's a shame, too. Bows actually got buffed a little in this game. They have, like, lance-like might now.
Well, that's good. Sword might. But still, can't shoot over buckets.
It's too bad Leonardo can't do shit. Jack shit with them.
But I've heard Shinon is pretty good in this game.
Oh, he's a fucking beast. The best bow user by a country mile.
I'm never going to forget the drunken conversation between Shinon and Ike in the camp. That was, like, probably one of the best moments of Path of Radiance.
It is one of my favorite conversations, just because I get to see Shinon act like a total dickbag, and I love it.
Yeah, but at the same time... At the same time as him being actually a dick... hit points, speed, defense! Again!
Slack.
Why does Edward level so much defense? It's insane. But yeah, but in addition to seeing that Shinon is like a dick, we also see a vulnerable side to him. Because we see why he's so pissed with Ike. Because he misses... Because he's grieving Grail. Pretty much. Yeah. You know, he refuses to accept...
Secretly grieving Grail.
Yeah, and he doesn't see...
He just can't accept Ike because, you know... Ike is, like, doesn't really deserve being title of Grail. But damn well he tries.
Yeah, you know, Ike's kind of bad, so I kind of agree with Shinon, but, you know.
You think he's bad in that in Battle of Radiance?
Oh, no, don't.
Wait to see Sir Buff McManroids in this game.
Wait, he's part of this game?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
What, you think they're going to just leave him out?
I don't know. It would kind of be cool if they did.
I really wish they did.
So, yeah, well, how about an Ike guy? Yeah, you know, he's still chilling in Crimea, fighting
when
for his friends.
Up, though, I won't say.
Ooh. Ooh, wow, cool. They have a custom battle. Don't tell me Micaiah has her own battle quotes with every single boss in this game, too.
I think she does.
Ooh, a Beoric Mage. Shiny, sparkly magic make me so scared.
We do not want your treasures. We mean thee no ill will. Step back and we will not harm you.
If the fire don't roar like a furnace, it doesn't scare me. I'm gonna rip your throat out.
So he basically said, ha ha, you're not a fire mage.
Haha, you're not a fire mage, yeah. You don't have to fires.
But, nuclear launch detected.
It'd be kind of funny if you clash into Liana, now she can use fire magic.
Ooh, cool. Yeah, so I heard that classes promote tree types in this game. What the hell?
Yes, they do. This game reintroduced the third tiers.
Is this why this game is like 100 chapters long?
Yeah. That's pretty much one of the biggest reasons, and kind of the reason why I wish they didn't really go with the whole third tiers route, because for really only for part one, tier one is only really relevant for like the early game, and then it's for like 60% of the game is just tier two stuff, and then the last part of the game is tier three, or right. Tier 2.5, but I'm getting ahead of myself.
Yeah, I think I fucked up here a little bit. I can't kill the boss with... How the hell am I supposed to get out of this mess? I can't kill the boss with Edward. I can't move away with Edward unless I place Nolan here. I don't think Nolan can kill the boss. He does... Actually, he can probably kill him. But he'll need to hit, and that's the problem. We never want to bank on Nolan actually landing a hit, do we?
Damn it, Nolan. If only you proc'd the point of speed, you wouldn't be in this mess.
Yeah, I mean, the only, I can drink a Vulnerary, but then Agony is going to attack Edward, bring him down to low health.
What you could do, Mangs, is just you can heal Edward and unequip him.
Ah! Smart guy. Because he's going to kill the boss on the counterattack. And he's going to Wrath. We know it's going to happen. There you go, Laura. Hold these.
You can actually just go to your items and select unequip from the menu.
Just because I can.
Nice.
I'm just gonna do it. Why not? There's no reason not to.
Yeah, from this, there's no reason. Just throw an axe at him.
Well, why do you have to, twirl the hand axe around three times before tossing it, Nolan?
Because fighters are fancy in this
He's
game.
He's look what I can do with this little axe. Alright, well. Time for the soft to be useful. Alright, I'm just kidding. Soft is always useful.
He is useful as long as you just keep using him.
Will you believe me, Ray, if I tell you that I actually managed to get soft killed in part 5?
I do believe you, actually, yes.
I badly misjudged his survivability against lance-wielding soldiers, and they just chipped away.
I do very much believe you. This is Radiant Dawn. Shit like this will happen.
Yep. So I didn't think it was possible, but it happened. Oh, right, you don't get a battle animation if you're unequipped.
No, not in this game.
Oh, Jesus Christ! What are these walls made of?
I don't know why they did that, but they did that.
Also, I've learned that healers can actually retaliate with their staves.
Yeah. Whole lot of fucking good that
create a lot of comic relief when Laura just bonked a bandit with one hit points on the in the head, like dunk.
I'll harm you.
It was so much fun. All right, now I'm pretty much sure I can kill this guy. I think I'm gonna try with Nolan or Roland first, see if we can actually do some damage to him, and then kill him with Edward. We'll see. Come on, stop twirling your axe around. Just throw it, goddammit. I wonder, do the bosses actually support with each other in this game? Because that's like a trademark from the previous games.
Oh, unfortunately, no bosses support, I think.
Because Paul and Jasmine...
Technically, they don't support, but if I do bring this up, this is probably going to be some spoilers, so I'm not going to say anything
Ray.
Else. I won't say anything else! Nope. No.
Laura's got her swords and Edward shoved her away. But it's fine. Because we can just walk around and give them to him.
Oh, did you notice that Pain and Agony have an authority star each?
What?
They have an authority star. Yeah, leadership stars are a thing in this game.
What? Really?
Yeah.
How do they work?
They function kind of like FE5, except the bonus is a little greater. One star for every one star, all units in the particular army get +5 hit and evasion.
Wow, really? 5? It was 3 in Tracia, I do believe.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay.
Of course, Makai has absolutely none, making your party jack shit.
Oh, how nice. Nice, of course not. You don't want to make Makai actually useful in any way. I get it. You know, if he misses this, I'm going to scream.
Come on, Edward.
That's okay.
Here's the lad.
You know, swords do not make that sound in real life.
Boonk!
What is he hitting with, a training sword?
That happened to me.
So now I just reduced the hit and avoid of all the remaining Lagoos by 5%. Didn't I?
Yeah.
Kick ass. So will there be like a Bishop Sias type guy in this game with like 10 stars?
No 10, unfortunately. Aww. Though 5 is the max, and it almost gives the same effect.
Ooh!
There you go.
I've gotten the coin, the Master Seal, now I only need the there's something over here, a scroll, I do believe?
Yeah, the scroll.
Oh, by the way, I gave Alan the skill which increases weapon level.
Ah, good.
Because I hear you get Antonin told me you get a silver lance very soon.
Yes, you do, actually. In 2 chapters from now, and yeah, he kind of needs all that sweet discipline so he can use the silver early.
I should probably use him a little bit then. Instead of just having him on Master Seal duty. Oh crap, they've opened up a hole in the wall. Oh no, oh, Meg was in range of a cat. To be quite honest, I'm not gonna restart if Meg dies. Cause I've already-
I was gonna say, like, do you care?
Also,
you're not gonna use her.
Ray, I'm actually considering benching Sorin just to piss people off in the comment section.
Hey, I don't- hey, hearing this from me? So I'm coming from a big-time Sorin fan. I love the kid to death, but I don't fucking blame you, friend.
Because, I don't know. I never liked Sorin in the previous game, but it's so much fun to see how pissed people get.
I do, but I understand them. It's like, oh, no Sorin, get later, bitches.
Yeah, and I've tried to avoid the spoilers like a plague. And you, of course, you don't have to confirm this or not, but from what I understand, he plays a very pivotal part in the plot in this game.
Say a thing.
Yeah, just saying because that's what people are getting most pissed over when I say I'm gonna bench Sorin. They're like, you can't bench Sorin, and then I'm like, hey, have you seen Rule 4 of Manx Let's Plays? Manx can do whatever the fuck he wants.
Fucking
he can't tell me what to do. All right, this is actually a rather peculiar situation right here.
If you attack him again, he's gonna de-shift.
This guy.
Yeah, he has 3 gauge left. Ooh, if you attack him again, he'll
okay, well, I need to kill this guy, too. So what I think I'll do is I'll do damage to this guy with Ileana, and then I kill this guy with Brolin, and then kill this guy with Edward and heal Edward. Sounds like a plan. Oh, 59% chance to hit Ileana. Really? Really?
Told you, man. Under magic is...
Let's just see how she fares in... Oh my god, she gets one-shotted.
Biorhythm also is a much worse beast in this game than it was in Path of the Radiance.
Look at that! Jesus! Look at that shit!
Nolan! What are you doing?
What the hell?
This is why you have an iron axe.
Right. This guy's scary, holy shit. Holy shit, why is this guy so scary? Alright, well, I think I'll need to place Edward here to not die, and then... No, fuck, what am I gonna do here? I need to retreat. No, I can't retreat. They'll catch up to me.
They're gonna catch you. They have 9 movement. They will catch you. And
yeah,
fast.
Running from tigers, not a good idea in any universe you're in. God damn it, I really don't know how to get out of this situation. Like, the only thing I can think of is hitting, doing 13 damage... And then somehow...
What's that tiger speed? I want to know.
Tiger speed? It's 12.
Okay, so if you unequip Nolan...
Or use hand axe.
Yeah. Or you just use the hand axe. And you'll get double.
Oh! Hallelujah. What would I do without you and Mr. Antonin? I'd probably still be on chapter 1. Like, seriously? Chapter 3? The fucking mansion? God. God!
I believe chapter 3 is pretty much the skill gate chapter for Radiant Dawn.
God!
God.
Once you get to that map, welcome to Radiant Dawn. Remember, you're here forever.
Wow, that was. I think I had 12 restarts on that map. It was absolutely fucking. Oh, what the hell did I do? Hey, game.
Just hit the camera.
This, I can't get used to this. Let's see, 10 damage plus 16 damage, 13 damage equals kill exactly. Wonderful. Yeah, like, the biggest problem with that game, or that map in general, was the fact that it introduces ledges, and archers fire down ledges, and you just...
The archers are devastated with ledges.
And, yeah.
The spirits firsthand.
The steel bow archers one-shot Leonardo as well.
Yeah, steel bow archers, welcome to hell, basically.
They do so much damage!
That's because the enemy archers have really good stats, and the steel bow is 10 might, so... Plus, factor in the ledge bonus, yeah, shit hurts!
Yeah, 50 plus hit, enjoy your avoidance. It's gone. And it's gone. Alright, okay, good. No wrath, Edward, no wrath. Ooh, ding, 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 ding. What will Edward
Come
get?
Come on, Edward, flex some more.
Edward will get... Hit points, strength, speed, luck, defense.
Oh my god, look at him! Flex! I love this man!
He's so good. He's so fucking good. Now he can... I do believe he can use steel... fucking steel swords without losing speed now.
Yes, he can. Steel swords weigh 12.
That is amazing. Okay, okay. Stay calm, man. Stay calm. You can do this. Like, I got to this point last time I recorded, and then I moved, like, Laura in range of the boss and lost Laura. It was, like, so fucking infuriating. I wanted to kill myself, literally. This game has invoked some very strong feelings on my part, I must admit.
This game has invoked some very dark secrets of Mangs.
Like,
this is what Radiant Dawn does to people. Seek help for your friends. This is not helpful.
And it doesn't help that Mr. Entenen decided to take a shot of rum every time I did something stupid. He got through that bottle in 15 minutes. And he was so he was so shit drunk, he couldn't do anything for the remaining part. He couldn't even formulate basic sentences. So no, ladies and gentlemen, if you're ever gonna have a drinking game and drink every time Mangs does something stupid, don't.
Wow, just... and I thought drunk Mangs when you're doing the ASDLP was a thing. Holy shit!
I think I only had like 5 glasses of white wine when I played that map. But I must say, that let's play I did when I recorded your hack, that was probably, I'm not sure if it was because of the alcohol, but it was the most fun I've ever had recording a Let's Play, except for Midnight Sun. It was the most fun I've had.
Well, if it had to be outdone by someone, it had to be Alfie.
Huh, what did you say?
If I had to be outdone by someone, it had to be from Alfie.
Yeah, Midnight Sun is amazing. But I really like, I can't believe I actually got through your chapter drunk. It must have been pure luck. I do remember, I think I lost, like, what is the guy's name? Galtrax?
Galfax.
Yeah. I think I lost him, because, you see, there was this bug which kept that Galtrax kept coming back every single time he died.
I'm trying to remember what happened, it's been so long since I've done the thing.
And whenever he died, I would just, you know, continue playing, and he'd just come back. Galtrak's the unkillable.
FE events are so weird to ROM hack. It's just, I didn't understand how permadeath worked until Alfred started working on Midnight Sun.
Oh, I can like, I have never done, okay, I'm just gonna make sure that Brolin won't actually get the, okay, good. Oh crap, 17. No. 11.
No defense.
15 damage.
26 attack. Kill me good.
Whew. Oh.
That point of defense, bro. Yeah. That point of defense.
I have never done extensive Fire Emblem ROM hacking, but I have dabbled in the code of other games. And just by looking at how the emulator games are coded, I can just imagine the sheer nightmare of Fire Emblem ROM hacking. I can see all the bugs, all the problems so clearly. Just how easily things can go wrong.
You have an idea. You have an idea, but yeah. Shit does get real with ROM hacking.
Yay.
There's money.
Woohoo!
I believe the skill is right next to that healing.
I do believe it's here.
To the left.
Here.
Yeah. To the left.
Okay. Cool. To the left. To the left. Everybody, to the left. All right. It's time for Edward to get another kill. Look at that. Look at that. Right. Doubling with the steel sword.
What a fucking boss. Look at him. I love Edward.
Who cares
so much
about other sword? Apparently, there's a really good swordmaster coming up.
Yes. Yes, there is a really good one.
I tried to ask Antonin if it was the guy I missed on the desert level, but he wouldn't respond. Stefan, I do believe his name is.
Yeah, his name is Stefan.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's that guy, or I thought it would be Lucia. I can't imagine who else it'd be. I'm trying to think about Myrmidons from the previous game. Seahark, maybe? There were so many. I don't know. I know you so badly want to say it.
I do. I'm not gonna say it.
I can hear it from your silence.
Because your fresh experience warms the cockles of my heart.
It is amazing to play a Fire Emblem game for the first time. You have no idea how much fun I'm having with this game. Like, it's been so long.
I can only imagine just the first time experience. Hell, my first time experience with this game. I freaking love this game. And then I realized the shit I was in, but full potatoes.
Why, thank you. Like, I've played Fire Emblem for... Let's see, I am 26, and I think I played my first Fire Emblem game when I was 14. So 12 years I've played Fire Emblem. So I've played the shit out of most every single Fire Emblem game there is to play.
I've played Fire Emblem for about 12 years, too. I started with 3-7, like, late 2003.
Yeah, same here. That was the first game. And, well, it just... And it's been so long since I had this feeling that it's not like a ROM hack of a fresh new game. It's fucking amazing. All right, I think Edward can take a hit from pain.
Ancient attack. Yeah, I think he will.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, they can't transform and then move, right?
Yes, they can.
They can, okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Wow!
Actually, they can't move, they can't, the unshifted Lagoos have 7 movement.
Okay, cool.
So they can only move 7, then shift, and then attack.
Alright, I see. I really want to get this chest over there, so I gotta make sure what I can do is I can try to pull this guy away with someone.
He has to go around the Lagoos by pain, he'd have to go around.
I could do Soth, maybe?
Get the scroll first.
Yeah, definitely. We want the scroll.
Beast, there you go. Beast foe.
So that is, from what I understand, it's basically the Slayer skill.
Mm-hmm.
From Fire Emblem Mates.
Whoever you get it to, all of their weapons will do effective damage toward beast type Lagoos.
Yeah. So that sounds pretty useful. I'm not sure how many Lagoos we're gonna find. God damn it, boss! Start moving, god damn it. I am not sure how many Lagoos we're gonna fight in this game. But I do remember the end game of Fire Emblem Path of Radiance was pretty fucking Lagoos heavy.
The Lagoos in this game, the fighting them are few and far between, but when you fight Lagoos, you fight a lot of them.
Okay, I see. God damn it, can the boss just start moving now? I'm getting nervous. Oh, stop it, please!
I am pretty sure Pain only moves if you aggro him.
He did start moving the other time, you see. I'm so fucking scared right now. I'm like leapfrogging. I'm not gonna get any bonus experience this game. Goodbye. Rest in peace, bonus experience. Was nice knowing you.
Peace, bonus experience. There he goes.
Okay. Oh, fuck. No. Okay, good. So the other Lagoos is not in range, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, thank God. Come here so I can taste you. The first time I encountered this boss, he said that to Laura, and I found it very creepy.
It doesn't happen. Also, I'm... sweet dodge, bro. I'm pretty sure
the fucking tiger.
The best animations in this game are the fucking best.
Oh my god, what were you saying?
I can say that without any impunity. The animations in this game are at their best in this one. Yeah, as I was saying, I'm pretty sure Lagoos are slowed down by sand while they're unshifted.
Ah, okay, cool.
Beric are good eats.
Listen up. We did not intentionally intrude on your territory. We just walked into your home and wanted to steal your treasure.
Thanks, Mikaya.
I'll listen
while I'm gnawing on your bones.
Thanks, Obama.
Yeah, because there's so much meat on Mikaya. You'd have like 2 mouthfuls, maybe. Meg, on the other hand.
Wow, Grim.
Yeah, no, she's all about that base.
Fuck.
Okay, goodbye, boss. It was nice knowing you.
Adios, pain.
Oh, well, I must say, I don't get a lot of experience in this game. Thank you, hard mode.
Yeah, another thing. Hard mode really...
Hit
really,
points, strength, skill,
you.
Defense, oh resistance.
My, he got res. Wow. Oh my god, he got res.
Can we all just have, like, 10 seconds of silence for... Never mind.
How does this happen?
I don't know. Edward happened.
Based Ed. Oh my god, your Edward is so good. I am jelly.
Yeah, like I am jelly of myself. That's how good he is.
Edward is going to carry you so hard through hard mode right now. You have no idea.
It is amazing. Wow, I can't move very far through sand at all, can I? All right, so fuck, how do we do this? Well, I need to lure him towards Edward.
Yeah, just bait him first, he's gonna move.
And then I can go and open the chest with Soth. Just don't kill him, Edward, please. Oh, I shouldn't have used the steel sword. That was stupid. Oh, I'm so gonna crit this guy now, I just know it. Okay, thank god. I really want this chest.
You're gonna have to unequip him now.
That's exactly what I'm gonna do. Hello. Let me take this. I just imagine how that must look in real time. It's like, hey, Edward, here!
Give me your swords right now.
Come at me.
Do it, I'm gonna mug ya.
Come at me, bro. Come at me. Oh, fuck. Shit. Micaiah, no! It's okay. It's okay. Rescue chains to the rescue. We're good. I love rescue chains. Ever since Have you watched the Fire Emblem 6 0% growth hard mode run by Don Don and Mecha?
I have seen a couple.
Ever since I watched that Let's Play, I've been hooked on rescue chains. No! Okay, good. He can't. Like, sweet. The rescue chains they pull off in that Let's Play. Like,
the rescue chains, some high-level strats right there, friends.
They ferry Roy across an entire map, like, in one turn. It's so beautiful to look at.
It is quite nice to just pull off a successful rescue. There you go, Seraphim. Woohoo! Like the icon it has, by the way.
Yeah, I'm gonna give that to Micaiah so hard. And I think just to get a little bit of weapon experience on Aaron, I'm gonna let Aaron get the kill.
Well, Mangs, you did it! You beat another chapter.
Unless he misses and the cat gets a crit. And even then.
Even then he's still
oh, yeah.
There you go. You got
oh,
him.
Oh my god. That was fun. Weapon level up. Yoon, wherever. Oh, that stupid bird. You can come out now. You, that bird.
Going bird.
It's a little strange. You're just jealous. Yeah, he's jealous of a fucking bird. Wait, I hear something. I can't hear anything. Someone's singing. It's coming from over there. Is it a Galder? Micaiah, wait.
It could be.
Is it...
Micaiah also has some pretty top lines in this chapter, and only this chapter.
Aww.
If she kept this up all game, I would have liked her a lot more. Alas, it was not meant to be.
Yeah, Marisu can only be interesting for so long. Is it Raisin?
No, it's not Raisin, but he's related to him.
Well, that looks like a mixture of Raisin and Liam.
This is Raphael.
I'm gonna pull a Professor Oak here. Are you a boy or a girl?
He's definitely a boy.
Okay.
Just gonna ruin the suspense right there for you, Megs. He is definitely a boy.
Okay, yeah, because in the introduction, I did say, ooh, who's that? She's cute. And Mr. Antonin called me gay.
Megs is a big gay. Confirmed.
She looked like a blonde... Oh, but no. Such a... Well, like Admiral Akbar once said, it's a trap!
You, hello! Who are you?
Oh, such a beautiful song.
So, get ready to see some badass wolves?
Yeah. Oh my god, I know Mr. Antonin have been looking forward to seeing this guy. He's gonna get so pissed when I tell him I recorded this part with you. He's like, I've been waiting so long to see abs! I am Raphael. A voice guided me here. Was it yours?
No, but I heard a voice that guided me here as well. Someone or something may want us both here.
You're a Lagoose, aren't you? One of the Heron. Oh, I should have called them subhumans like the Soth of old. One of... Filthy subhumans. One of the Heron clan and two of the Beast tribe, right?
That is correct, Beok Youth.
Your white wings reveal you're the Heron of royal family. Are you related to Prince Raisin by any chance?
Raisin? My younger brother? You know of him?
You could say that. We served in the same company for a while. Yeah, Soren was busy cleaning the bench while Raisin was off dancing.
What? Are you suggesting that my brother is still alive?
Yeah, he is still alive.
Kicking.
Woohoo! And as far as I know, your father, the king, and the princess Lianne are as well. Unless something happened, all three of them live in the royal palace of Gallia, country of the beast tribe. Oh, I want to see Kanagus again.
Unbelievable. My father and my sweet Lianne, they're still with me? Oh, goodness. Oh, I'm not alone. Not anymore.
Pull yourself together, friend.
Who is Nalia? Oh, don't worry. I don't do furries. Except for Leth. Leth is okay. Sorry, but... Raphael? Oh my god.
Oh, look at him.
Oh, Jesus so Christ.
Weird. I love this guy.
That guy lifts. Like, I don't care.
He lifts and then some. Volg is the fucking man. Look at him.
Holy shit.
Nalia is cool too, but Volg.
Hello, and you are?
I am Nalia, Queen of Hatari, and this is Volg, my loyal servant. Our kingdom lies far east of here.
There's a country on the other side of the desert?
As I said, we have just traveled from here.
Oh my god, this music is so fucking beautiful. Like, seriously, it is like... I get, like, mesmerized over the music right now. It is so good.
Very good music. As I said, the soundtrack is pretty damn good.
Until we met Raphael, we didn't know there were countries on this side of the desert. After all, no one has ever crossed the desert of death and lived to tell of it.
And you know, except for the people who did cross it and then lived to tell of it, since you... Like, never mind. I hate that a lot. You went into the forest, and no one who's ever gone in there have returned to tell the tale, but apparently someone did in the first place. Anyway, without Raphael's guidance, we would never have survived the crossing.
My people, the Heron clan of the Serenes, were blamed for the murder of Begnia's empress. Begnia's mob rose up in rage and massacred them. I thought the whole of my clan, my entire race, had been wiped out. I wandered the desert in despair. If not for the queen, I would have died. In Atari, I vowed to dedicate my life to her. And yet every night for these past 3 years, a voice has called out to me. Day by day, it has grown stronger. Until the voice led me to you all. Your news brings such joy. Father, Raisin, Lianne, my beloved family. Oh, my thanks to thee. Oh, goodness. Ah, this guy is really poetic, isn't he?
He is very...
Raphael, you talk too much. Control yourself.
Oh, my love. She's great.
You, Beric. What's the best route to Gallia?
For a group of Lagoos, traveling through the Dane countryside would be suicide. It will take you longer, but we could take you as far as Crimea.
You would be grateful. By all means, let's travel together. But why go to Crimea? Why not travel directly to Gallia?
Entering Gallia by yourselves would be nearly impossible. The man you need to meet to get you into Gallia actually resides in Crimea. That man, Ike, is in contact with King Kanagus and his advisors. There's no doubt in my mind that he's the man you need.
Right, Lord Ike, hero of the Crimean liberation, leader of the Grail mercenaries, and father of Soth's children?
What?
Father of Soth's children. She's basically saying...
Did they have sex?
Dude, stop sucking Ike's dick so much.
Father of Soth's children, what? I don't even want to know.
That's that trademark wit of Micaiah, that's the last time she ever has it.
Uh-huh. Oh, fathers of Soth's... Oh, right! Yeah, because... I know why she said that now. Because she is actually... She thinks that Soth fanboys Ike too much.
Yeah, exactly.
Right, that. She was being sarcastic. Yeah. I was like, what? Father of Soth's children? Well, did they have a child? Okay, never mind.
Wow, thanks.
Anyway, I got through chapter 4. I feel very good about myself. Only one fail. Thanks for joining me, Ray. It was a lot of fun.
Maybe, no problem.
Maybe you'll come back one time.
Maybe.
Who knows? At any rate, please give this video a thumbs up and a comment. It is all really appreciated. And,
it really helps this channel, don't you know?
It really does. Thanks, Ray. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Shit, I knocked over something. Thanks.
I've been made.
I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.
Later.